Refresh.
Yeah. Okay. Being 7 o'clock on Thursday, April 6th, call the meeting of the Finance Committee to order. First time, pledge allegiance.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
So again, just to note, this meeting is being recorded for playback. First item on the agenda, approval of the minutes. We'll start, we've got a few months to report on. February 16th, yes.
Would it be in line, observance of the silence of former town finance committee member who passed away last week?
James Bazinet.
Mr. Bazinet.
By all means. Thank you.
Thanks.
So February 16th. Minutes. Need a motion?
Make a motion to approve the minutes of February 16th, 2017.
I second.
Any discussion? All in favor?
Aye.
Opposed? Abstained? Next is the meeting of March 9th.
I make a motion to approve the minutes for March 9th, 2017.
Second.
Motion and a second. Any discussion?
Yes. On page... page 6. The paragraph at the top starts on page 23. Property tax levy represents 49% of the total general fund and operating revenues and 0.75% Webster option excise to the state's meals tax. State revenue $15,373,000, 2.9% increase. Local aid estimates from the state, 2.9% in revenue, 25% on assessments. I'm not following where this is all coming from. So I'm not sure
you
that
have
it,
the minutes
that
of March 9th.
Am I 9th? I'm not going to. So I'm looking that maybe we want to strike this just because I'm not sure the reader's going to understand what the point is.
I didn't understand. Excuse me, I didn't understand what you said. You can do the microphone too, please.
So I'm not sure what these minutes refer to and the point they're making.
What page do you want to use? What does it say?
Pages aren't numbered. 1, 2, 3.
Third from the
four,
last page.
5, 6. Page 6. Top.
Well,
part up here.
How does it start?
On page 23.
Okay. I believe that was in Mr. Bullitt's handouts. You read it, and I think that's what he also reported to us.
Sorry, which paragraph?
It's around page 5 or 6, either the end of page 5 or the beginning of page 6. Mine is on page 5. Starts with on page 23, I'm assuming that's of the budget.
Oh yeah, yeah.
Well, then we could give the reader a little bit more information as to what we're talking about.
On page 23 of the budget.
Perhaps.
I agree, sir. It's pretty sporadic. I don't really follow what I was also present at the meeting. I don't really follow what's going on in the paragraph.
It does come from Mr. Willison's handout from
the budget,
on page 23.
If anybody read it, it was there.
Perfect.
But the minutes are for a reader of...
It doesn't say where, on page 23 of what? I think that's what... On page 23 of the budget, maybe.
It should be noted. Minutes should be noted.
Yeah, just a little more clarification as to what we're saying if we want to keep it in there. And then I have one more edit on the next page, 7, third paragraph down, the last sentence. Custodian eliminated from town, now covered by the senior center, and I believe it's a grant.
I'm sorry?
Yeah, it should say grant.
It's a senior center grant.
It just says senior center. It should say senior center grant.
Those are my only edits.
Can I have another motion to accept these minutes with those two edits?
So moved.
Second? Any other discussion?
Gentlemen, I would just like to comment on the minutes of the meetings. We have never had anyone do such an extensive detail of minutes. You know, minutes are not supposed to be extensive. Now, has our secretary been advised that this is the way we want it, through the chair?
We're going to talk about that after the meeting tonight, because there's also...
After the meeting?
After the meeting. If you have anything about this, this set of minutes was taken off of the YouTube.
I understand that.
Okay.
But has the chairman made any direction to our clerk that this is the way you want it, or should be presented?
I just said after this meeting tonight, we as a committee can accept or reject those...
Why is it an agenda item?
Huh?
Why is it an agenda item?
There is an agenda item.
You said after the meeting.
I'm going to talk to her about minute format based on the regulations that were presented to us on Monday at the mandatory meeting for open meeting law and record keeping. Were you at that meeting? That mandatory meeting?
No, oh, I know I went to the law open meeting.
Oh, okay.
I've been around too long, remember?
Okay.
Well, all I'm saying is, Board of Selectmen ever got this? You think they would read and understand what's going on? Better be brief and to the point, and it's not a criticism of the clerk. I think something's going on that I don't really like, and I like to discuss that after the meeting.
We can put it on the agenda if you want to play this out that way. It's up to you. We'll talk about that later. Right now, we're talking about these minutes.
That's exactly right. That's what I'm doing.
Okay, we have a motion, and we're discussing
you
whether...
You said any discussion. I said yes.
Okay.
That's my discussion.
Okay. Any other discussion? All in favor of that motion?
Aye.
Aye. Opposed? Okay. The minutes of March 23rd.
Approved as written.
Second.
Any discussion? All in favor?
Aye.
Aye. Opposed? Motion carries. Okay, just next on the agenda, committee appointments discussion. Mr. Ralph asked to be on the agenda, and he also presented to the Board of Selectmen at their meeting last week. The discussion revolves around the pending charter change in membership and how to transition from a 15-member board to a 9-member board should that pass a town meeting in Ballenden.
Good evening. As you just heard, I sent an email to both committees, to the Board of Selectmen and the Finance Committee, asking what their direction, if they could give me some direction, thinking that we should all be on the same page as to how we proceed from this point. I have one vacancy presently open. I think the Board of Selectmen have one or two open. But if we fill those past the three that charter review has recommended that we drop down to 9, then something would have to be bumped off, or people would have to be bumped off in a year. So my thought was to not fill those vacancies, I sent the email, I believe the board of selectmen were in agreement not to fill those, we have to get into a situation where we have to pick people to drop off. I don't know how you people feel about that, this is your committee, so we'll have to see what we thought.
Only my one observation is there's five elected ones, and it's, I couldn't really stop someone from running, so.
Yes.
Yeah, my thought is if, you know, right now we're okay, we're above, you know, with your appointments, we're above the three appointments, if we were to move the charter to three. But I think at any point in time between now and that approval, if that should get below three, we may ask to fill that so that we remain at a level of three appointed by the moderator.
Yeah, and that's fine. I don't have a problem with that. Again, my thought is those, if you have enough people and we don't need the two from the board of selectmen and the two from the town moderator to be filled,
yeah,
that we leave those open at this time. Obviously, the elected ones drop off every year.
Right.
Anyways,
yeah.
So then whoever would be out at that time would just not be
able
to run again until the fall of the year when somebody else was up.
Mm-hmm. Yes.
It's my understanding that if we have a charter change anytime and it's an elected position that has to be eliminated, that elected officer stays until the position or the end of that particular elected position. When do you intend on submitting a new charter change to the town meeting? October or May of next year?
I can, being chairman.
I'm asking Mr. the moderator.
I'm the chairman of the committee.
I thought you just picked the committee.
I just picked it, he's the chairman.
When do you plan on, October or May?
Right now, we're planning, we're looking at a possibility of October, but if not, it'll be May.
Okay, October would be perfect.
Yeah, so.
May would be a little bit.
Or November, I would.
Yeah, so. I copied you on the email with the Bob Craver, right? So there is no town election in November, so in order for the charter to be approved, it had to be approved by the ballot. So the next election is not until May 18.
So he did answer you?
He did answer.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
Okay, so it would be May.
Yeah, so then we run into a predicament if it's in May, because eventually we will have two more people running or one more person running for office here. And it'd be a simultaneous vote, and what do you do with a simultaneous vote?
Yeah, so I think the charter is going to have to put transition language into it, so whatever the charter committee agrees to, we'll go into the charter, say, okay, if it is more than the nine, this is how we're going to adjust it. So it might be leave everyone in there until their term expires, or it might be get the best looking one off, I don't know, so.
We've just started undertaking the transitional language because there's other things that are in the charter that's gonna require a transition.
The reason I ask, I'm the proponent of the one that moved it from 9 to 15 to begin with.
Gotcha.
Yeah, I did that at the town meeting.
9 to 15.
Yeah, we went from 9 people to 15, yes.
We
5 and 5.
Okay. So, again, there will be transitional language that's going to be shared with everyone, that's going to be shared with the town at public hearings. There'll be some educational opportunities on that. We're just not ready. We've just sought legal opinion on the work we've done these 9 months. So we'll be carrying it through the spring and summer and probably into the fall with a town meeting scheduled sometime in the fall with a ballot for May.
And I was officially sworn in today, so you have to deal with me now.
No swearing in this building.
So I think, you know, we're clear on that, unless something changes.
Right,
in that.
Just send me an email or a letter.
Sure, yeah.
Something arises and meet somebody else.
Yeah.
Move forward with that.
Yeah.
Last thing, if I could say, is a little public service announcement. I've advertised, but we have two companies coming in, a week from tonight. 4:30 to 6:30 in this room to demonstrate electronic voting for town meeting. So more the merrier, to get opinions and thoughts on the two systems that we present.
When is that?
Same time this?
Tonight, week from tonight, in this room, 4:30 p.m. to 6:30 p.m.
Thank you.
There'll be two vendors.
Holy Thursday Mass at 7 o'clock, so.
And it's not like you have to be here from 4:30 to 6:30. Is it come in, drop in, and leave whenever, or is it?
The first company will be presenting from 4:30 to 5:30. They'll do their presentation, then they'll take questions. The second company will present from 5:30 to 6:30, doing the same thing. They'll present.
So it's a whole, you should stay for the whole show.
Right. Okay. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you. Okay, town administrator monthly report.
All right.
You have the packet. And I think there was some follow-up questions from the February.
Yes, sorry, let me finish writing that down. Yeah, so from the February one, there was a couple of questions that I want to follow up on. The first one was code enforcement. It's actually the inspectional services, the wiring, plumbing, and gas inspectors. So they were paid their regular stipend through December. And since then, they've been paid the permit, the certain dollar amount per permit. That's an issue now because they're getting like a third of what they were getting paid. So that all needs to be addressed. So not exactly sure how to do that yet. So we may have to put money into the budget to either give them a stipend or somehow give them more of the permit fee, which would mean less revenue coming into the town.
Through the chair, while that's subject. Again, I'm the proponent of the inspectors going to a fee, but we had originally sat with them and it was tentatively agreed at 75-25 split. They would get 25%, we would get 75%. And then it went to $10 for some reason, what nobody knows. In the course of your investigation as to what the hell went on with the $10 per permit fee, you may want to find out who changed it and why, when it was all of the inspectors met and were in agreement, and that's why they actually did go for the idea.
Yeah, and there was some confusion on their part too, because they thought they were getting the stipend plus the dollar amount per inspection. So maybe that's why they agreed to that. I have no idea. I wasn't there. All I know is that the way it's working now is not going to work for the future.
Well, that's why I asked you to go on your investigation to find out what the heck happened.
Yeah.
So we may have to transfer something for this year's budget?
No, we're going to have to, yes.
And it's still unsettled for 2018?
For 18, yeah. Yeah.
Why do we have to?
Because we paid them the stipend for the 6 months, and there was no budget for the stipend. So there's a deficit in those accounts.
Yes, there was.
Yeah, so.
Through the chair, the interim town administrator started paying on a 1/12 basis, right?
Yep, yeah, so they got paid 1/12 for the first 6 months, and then it stopped and they started getting paid per permit. But the 6 months was never budgeted, so there's a deficit. One's like 4,000. It shows it in the report.
Through the chair, how can we pay someone or people when we don't have an appropriation? Violation of state law, isn't it? Yes. Say yes.
Yeah, you need an appropriation. Yes.
Right. So from the get-go, we're violating state law. Now, I can understand how these inspectors feel. You know what? There are other people out there.
You know? There are other people. I don't think anyone would come for what they're currently making per permit.
Yeah. Go ahead.
My next question is, was there any study done between towns, Grafton, Dudley, Charlton, Oxford, Douglas? Was any study done on what happens there? Because Dudley's on the permit fee.
Yep, so they do that. The building inspector spoke with at length about it, so he said usually in those communities it's 70-30.
It's a different split.
Yeah, yeah. But it was like, I think he was saying the 70 went to the inspector and the 30 went to the town.
Yeah.
So.
There was confusion in that.
Yeah. Anyway, I guess in general this is not settled and I need to find something to make it fair for the inspectors and balance the budget.
Incorporate that in the budget, so.
But let's go back to the beginning. Why are we in this predicament right now? Because in a Monday night selectmen's meetings, they did not do what they were supposed to do, and that's my opinion. By adopting the fees that were presented to them weeks beforehand, before the fiscal year started. A lot of troubles coming from that board.
Luckily, I get to play ignorant.
Yes. let's put the blame where it belongs. You have the powers to be, and they filed it up royally.
Okay.
That's my opinion.
All right. Okay, next item.
So there was a question with the police department and their Quinn pay. So the Quinn bill is now built into the regular rate. So. So in the 18 budget, you'll notice the Quinn bill line zero because it's all built into the regular salary.
Is that contractual?
Yes.
Why? I know you didn't do it through the chair. Mm-hmm. I know you didn't do the contract. But you know, we're getting less and less information this way.
How's that?
I mean?
How are you getting less information?
There's not a line item budget.
Well, it's just built, so in the police contract, it has a rate for a patrolman that has a PhD, a master's degree, an associate's degree, and no degree. So he's just paid that hourly rate. So
it's
in a way.
Rolled into the rate, their hourly rate?
Their hourly rate, yeah.
And not separated by the Quinn funding.
Right.
I think the question is, how do we know, you know, right
how
now?
Much, how much Quinn actually costs?
Yeah.
You don't really know exactly what the Quinn costs because now it's just built in and you get paid more if you have a higher degree.
Is that typical?
I'm assuming then that there is no increase reflected on the Quinn bill in conjunction with cost of living increase. Right.
So the cost of living is on the base rate, and now they're paid on the base rate. The Quinn or the education is built into the base rate. So.
So that's going to inflate. That's going to contribute to cost of living.
It would.
So that's a change.
Yeah. All right.
So in other words, this is a sweetheart contract.
Call it whatever
you
want.
Yeah, it's a contract.
It's history.
One last thing. Can check it quickly, but you can answer it more quickly. Is the overtime a separate line item?
Yeah. In the police department, yes. In every department, it is.
Why? Why isn't that the same as the Quinn bill?
Because you.
Same principle. Put it all in one lump sum and we just let it be one total.
I mean, not really. I think you know that it wouldn't be because you have to pay them depending on how many hours.
For some reason, why the police requested that and it was accepted. And I'm not being negative one or whatever, but there's something there. But we don't see it out of sight, out of mind, right?
All right. Yeah.
I know you don't. You can't say anything.
So back, the questions from February, another one was intergovernmental assessment. So that is just a 1/12 of the state assessments, 1/12 of it. each month, so in February it had been 7, so should have been a 7th of, or 7/12 of our state assessment. Was that it? I think it was.
Yeah, I think so.
So.
So on to March, or?
Yeah.
Like to just say generally, looking at March, we're with 2/3 of the way in to this fiscal year. And, you know, with 3 months remaining, and I think there's some departments doing better than others.
Mm-hmm.
And have you spoken with those departments and shared their budget to date with them? How is that? Yeah.
Yeah, so.
I mean, you know, typically when a department head is starting to, you know, toward the end of the year hitting the ceiling, there's some feedback.
Right. So, actually, a lot of the problem ones are my departments, so don't tell anyone. But I went through, and some of the accounts that we're having trouble with are, the inspectional services for all those inspectors.
Yeah.
Those are all all deficits. Elections. So we're about. I think we have just a slight deficit right now, but we still have one more election. So that's going to be an issue. So that's going to be like $13,000 negative by the end of the year. And that was because in October or in November, we had all the early voting leading up to the presidential election.
Was that not anticipated last year when we budgeted for 17? I know we budgeted for an extra election because it.
Yeah, right.
Wasn't it our first year doing early voting, though?
It is the first year. I'm trying to remember when they mandated it. I don't remember when they said that.
Yeah.
I have no idea.
And also, we've got 2 voting locations now, so
yep.
that will contribute.
Through the chair, Jim, the early voting, that requires you go to town clerk, correct?
We don't have open doors
with the registrars or whatever to come in and early vote, do we? You go to the town clerk, is that correct?
Right, so I don't know how you guys did it here, but I'm assuming you had polling places that were open.
Just the town clerk's office.
Just the town clerk's office?
But
that's the only thing.
But I think they were extended hours. I think there were some Saturdays that they were open, if I remember correctly, and a couple of nights during the week that they were open later.
I don't know, but we're talking about $13,000, right?
It will be $13,000.
So we have to pay somebody. Who do we pay?
Yeah, we can break it down more, but the reason it was over.
$100 on a salary, correct?
Yeah.
And a stipend through the registrars.
Yeah, so there was election workers. If you want to break down, I can try to get that.
Well, you say it's for $13,000. And then, like Jim says, if you budgeted for one extra election, and unless and until there's a special election, like the Senate, the Congress, or
yep.
something or other, you know, that should be budgeted almost to the penny beforehand.
And if I think those votes had to be opened at the voting by the voting
yes.
workers,
they
and fed in, so that was extra. Above
time
the walk-in voting for that day, so.
I want to get something clear. I walked in, I signed a thing, I put it in an envelope, and I handed it to the town clerk. You as an elected official, me as an elected official, have a duty and an obligation to the members of the town of Webster. If we're required to work 40 hours a week, we work 40. If we're required to work 80, we work 80 because we're an elected official. We don't get a stipend for that. If this new early voting
mm-hmm.
is going to become a problem and the town clerk is going to have to call people in, we should know that in advance. Otherwise, if he has to come in on a Friday, or he has to come in on a Saturday, or he has to even come in on a Sunday, that should be part of his elected official duties and should not cost us 5 cents.
I think it was all for election workers, not for the
why?
Clerk.
It's his.
It was his duty and obligation. You didn't need more than one person in that office to collect those envelopes. Everybody came in and signed and gave him the envelope. There's no work to that other than to sit there and look at the walls till somebody walked in the door.
Yeah. So I'll tell you what I'll do. I will get a breakdown of the cost for the early voting, and that'll explain all this.
So we had a lot of early voting.
Yeah.
Thank God, not
worth. Has the budget we had a lot for 18 been accounted?
Yep, so I spoke to him about that, and he's like, it should be fine.
And is there a way to reduce that?
Yeah, yeah, right, can we, yeah, like you said, can we just have the clerks be there, so.
In the years of presidential elections, there's 2 to 3 times as many voters out as
right.
years that there are.
Yeah.
I think that was anticipated.
And we may not be required to do early voting, especially in November. We probably won't be because it's not a gubernatorial election or a presidential election. A couple of other problem areas. Town offices custodial overtime. So custodian was let go in January or February. So the other custodians have been covering it, and it's overtime. So in the budget process, kind of delayed the hiring of a new one because we didn't know if it was going to be part-time, full-time, whatever. It's been settled that it's going to be part-time, paid for by the Senior Center Formula Grant. So I have resumes. I want to hire someone next week. So that will
mitigate.
At least cut down the bleeding. The building and grounds maintenance for the town office. If you remember, the elevator was broken and cost $14,000 to fix. So that was just wasn't anticipated at all.
Really, Jim?
Yeah.
We have $50,000 or $55,000 sitting in a town hall
stabilization. We do.
Yes.
Yep. That needs.
And as was specifically, the elevator wasn't stated by the previous town administration. That was the specific intent.
So then that would need 2/3 of town meeting to vote it out of the stabilization. So I had to pay the bill for. Yeah, you're right. There is 55. I think it's actually 60,000 available now, but I cannot use that to pay the elevator maintenance bill or repair bill.
Through the chair, can you bring that to town meeting to?
I could do that. Yes.
Well, it should.
It should be a warrant article. Yes. Make that a recommendation with a motion.
I don't think.
If you don't do it, we do it.
I don't think we need a motion, but
yeah.
We can make it.
Yeah, if the town administrator doesn't do
right.
it, we can do it.
Right.
All right. Obviously, the snow is a problem.
Yeah.
Not today.
That was good.
Thank goodness. We've had enough.
Yeah.
That last storm was.
So I'm sorry, Mr. Chairman.
That last storm was tough.
Yeah.
Let me tell you something.
Anytime it snows a foot, then rains a foot on top.
So, Jim, I'll have to admit, I did not do my sidewalk. When I have a hydrant in front of my house, I asked my neighbor to come and plow the hydrant because it involves the neighborhood emergencies. I did not do my sidewalk.
Well, I'll bring my ticket book out next time it snows.
And you know, never mind.
So another problem area is the Veterans Department. So
yeah,
I don't know what's with the salary there, but because I'm not even sure exactly when the new director was hired. It was after the beginning of the fiscal year.
Yeah,
so I think he was hired at a higher rate than.
Okay.
So that's a problem. Also, the veteran benefits seem to be running high. Probably about $10,000, $11,000 higher than we budgeted.
Yeah. Can I ask about the SWCC assessment, the $400,000 that's in the police dispatch?
Yeah, where it's.
It was budgeted, nothing's been paid.
Oh, $400,000. Probably because we haven't charged it ourselves yet.
It's after police.
Yeah, so it's like
Before fire.
240.
121.
Yeah, I mean, we just haven't, yeah, we pay ourselves, basically, so.
Yeah.
I mean, that hasn't happened. That hasn't been, the accounting of it hasn't happened.
So it's not reflected.
You know, through the chair, with all due respect, the last town administrator for 8 years had the accountant by his side with her big books. How come you don't demand that?
It's just the way I want to run. Are there any other questions about the budget? I think I covered the problem areas.
The only thing toward the end, two things. I see that on liability insurance, the police fire accident insurance is high, and also that insurance deductible was paid on the end there, $7,500.
Yeah.
Can you describe them?
I forgot what the deductible was. The police fire accident, that's what it is. So it was.
Why so far over budget though?
So I'm not exactly sure, wasn't here, but they switched insurance companies. So I think the general liability probably dropped, between general liability and workers' comp, that went down when the police fire accident went up. So overall,
it's still gonna be in that.
Yeah.
Overage.
I don't have that with me, I'm sorry. You mentioned something about $7,500.
The insurance deductible. It wasn't budgeted, but there's been $7,500 spent.
Well, that is our deductible when a court case goes against the town.
That's what I wanted to find out.
That's exactly right. And we've had one, maybe people are gonna have two and more. So my deductible was $7,500. That's the explanation.
Thank you.
Yeah, I'll look up. I have to, the internet's kind of iffy in here. So I'll get back to you guys on that.
Okay. Okay, on to anything else on? Okay, on to old business. The FY15 certified free cash balance statement.
Chairman, I have a question on that. Is that FY16 or is it 15? Because it was dated June 31st or July 1st of 16. I'm just.
It is 15, fiscal year 15. So, yeah, basically it's the balance after 15 was all done.
Correct. Okay.
So you have in the packet, it's a negative $3 million. All that's basically due to the Park Avenue School construction project. So we spent about $15 million on the project. We only borrowed $10 million on the project. So that's the problem. We're now working to rectify and borrow the additional money that we should have. So that's going to be a borrowing that takes place in May.
So that's just borrowed additional borrowing off of the original amount that was approved.
Yeah,
by the town
meeting. So the town approved like 46 million, maybe it was only 42 million. Because MSBA requires you to authorize the entire project.
Yeah.
They reimbursed a lot, can't remember, 23 million maybe.
Yeah.
And the town was responsible for the remainder, which is about 15 million. We borrowed 10, not the 5.
Through the chair. Any reason why we wouldn't want to borrow the 5?
Why we wouldn't want to?
Yeah, I mean, if we knew it was going to be 15 million operation, why would we only borrow 10?
Yeah, so this is a long time ago.
Yeah.
I would say that they didn't want to incur the interest on all 15 million at once. So they borrowed 10 with the idea, when that gets close to being all spent, we'll go borrow the other 5. So you save the interest on the 5 million for a year or two. That's what I would guess why they would do that. That makes sense.
Yeah.
Yes. So
very good explanation. That is the way it worked. We know that, you know that. I'm not going to say anything further. Somebody who's an employee of ours or employees of ours has the obligation to know when we have to borrow what. I've been in town government and you have also.
No, definitely, I will admit that it never should have gone negative, but.
I'll leave that in your hands because that's a personnel problem.
Yes, it is. So that is, it never should have gone negative. It makes sense to not have borrowed all at once if that's what you won't intended to do. But it should have never been all spent.
To the chairman.
Shouldn't still be an issue.
Yes.
To the chairman, question. The financial department, assessor, collector, treasurer, and accountant meet every Tuesday, am I correct?
They do not.
Maybe not. They're scheduled to meet every Tuesday. Let me put it a different way. They're scheduled to meet every Tuesday as a group to assure the taxpayers that their money is being handled properly. Where was the ball dropped? Can we find that out?
So there's a lot of people that could have been
involved. I don't want personnel. I just want to know where the ball was dropped that we didn't know we did. We're going to have a nobody. I've talked to quite a few people in municipal government in other towns and this town. They've never heard of negative free cash. It's a new one on all of us.
It's a big problem, and it should never have happened. I'll just say I'm taking care of it, and
I have great faith in you. Great faith.
Through the chair.
The people out there have to know you're doing your job.
Yeah, yeah.
Yes.
Through the chair. Now, does that mean we have to go out and borrow another $3 million?
So
cover these deficits?
Well,
it means we're going to borrow it's not quite $5 million, but the $5 million that we spent on the building, we are going to borrow that. Mm-hmm. So you may have heard that we have trouble with cash flow. I mean, this is why, because we spent almost $5 million that we really didn't have at the time, and we've just been able to patch it for a while now.
Yeah.
You know, a person like myself, I just need to know how we're going
yep.
to
yeah. So we. Yeah. So this is negative right now. So we borrow the 4. I can't 6 or 8. So we borrow that money in May. So that will cover this deficit. Also there. So we have, when free cash gets certified in 18, we'll have, for 17, we'll have the 15 money that we would have normally gotten, we'll have the 16 money we normally would have gotten, and we'll finally get it all in the FY17 free cash certification. So that should be a fairly healthy certification, yeah. Which there is, I mean, some of it's already spoken for, because we have to repay the stabilization funds, and yeah.
The ironic thing about it was, I know it's all history now, we had a couple of town meeting articles saying take so much for free cash, which had to be, you know, withdrawn. Those articles had to be withdrawn.
Mm-hmm.
Well, that was before your time and whatever, you know. But I mean, it just goes to show that you have a job to do, and I hope you do it, and I hope you do it right.
Well, I've been busy.
Okay, next item, the 215 audit management letter. I'd just like to say, I think, you know, something that we've all known, but recommendations are to have policies and procedures in place. And that's nothing new in this management letter. It was in a previous management letter. And it's good to see that a policy team has evolved and is working on getting financial policies and procedures in place. I hope that some of the policies that were pointed out in the management letter are some of the top 12 policies that the committee is working on. later in the budget, we have...
The liaisons. We're not a committee.
Okay, yeah, the liaisons.
Yeah. Yeah, it's a difficult group.
Nobody gets along.
But the policies that they're specifically recommending, are they on your list of to do?
Yeah, they will be incorporated, right?
Yes.
They may not be recognized by these names, but they will be.
Yeah.
Okay.
So I will say that 15 management letter is very, very similar to the 14 management letter, so I don't think anything on here is a surprise to you.
I believe it's also similar to the 1997 management letter.
Along the several years. Same thing. No improvement.
Anybody else have any?
So real, the new stuff at the end, GASB, so...
Yeah.
Our OPEB liability will need to be reported on the balance sheet. And then the procurement, so the federal procurement laws are different than the state ones, so if we are using federal money, we just have to make sure we're obeying the right law.
And that's for over $3,000 purchases?
Yeah, so that's the biggest difference is, and under Mass General Law, if it's under $10,000, you just use best business practice.
Yeah. Multiple quotes or whatever.
Yeah, you just should know you're getting the best deal. Yeah. And it's only $3,000 for the federal money, so.
Brother Jeff, the management letter is actually, I'll say it like this, because I work with a lot of them. There's the report card, quite frankly, of where we're at after the audit. Just one thing disturbs me in this, and that's the improved internal audit function. You know, again, you're more the wax town administrator, but it's pretty evident what did not occur.
Yeah, so I will say that they were not happening. Actually, the town accountant has worked on this. She told me this week that it has been reconciled through February, so we're addressing that.
But says it's got to be done timely, which is usually monthly.
Yeah, I agree. Cash receipts should be reconciled every month.
It's tough when you got to go back and do it.
Yeah, because it's like...
Well, it seems to be tough.
Twice the work.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Okay.
I'm sorry? It will be from now on.
Okay, next item, the FY18 budget. I just wanted to point out that, you know, as I think we've realized at the tri-committee meeting, that we're looking at a deficit of $340,627. And that's based on the assumption that the revenues built into that budget are accepted. And I think the biggest one that's debatable is the $180,000 on the late fees assessment that I think the Board of Selectmen are meeting on.
Yeah, it's on their agenda for Monday.
On their agenda to decide on. And that will have... You know, that could further put this in the negative.
Right.
And
yeah, I feel confident that they'll vote for it, but maybe they'll surprise me.
But in any event, we've got a minimum of 340,000.
Yeah, so did we adjust it down to 320 after making that change for the police? Oh, it went from 360 to 340?
Yes.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. So that's
thanks.
The latest that was presented.
Yeah. Yep, that's right then. Yeah.
And the school committee at the tri-committee meeting was asked to, you know, put that burden.
Yeah.
And I do know that they've, that team has met at least twice since the tri-committee meeting, and they are going to report next Tuesday, the 11th, I think, to the school board. A recommendation.
Yeah, I think that's true. I think they might not actually vote on it until the Tuesday after, which would be like the 24th or 5th? 25th.
18th.
What's
wouldn't
that?
It be the 18th?
Tuesday, the 18th?
Actually, it would be their next meeting, which would be on the 25th.
Yeah.
So, that's a little late in the year.
What's that gonna do to you?
Well, that, it depends. If they vote what I recommended, everything's fine. If not, then, that week, I decide what gets cut somewhere. And it's still, maybe town just votes that what I propose for the school department is what the budget is, so. I've had lots of talks, conversations with them, so I think it's gonna all work out. But.
Budget season comes once a year, like Christmas, and New Year's and Easter, right?
Yeah. Did you say emergencies?
No, budget season.
Oh, budget season. That, it seems like a 6-month-long season.
Why would the school, I'll say it like this, and I don't mean it that way. Why wouldn't the school, why are they dragging their feet when they have to give us an obvious, give you an obvious answer of yes or no? I mean, we're weeks away from a town meeting.
Right. I don't want to speculate. That's the question you should ask them.
I know where you're coming from, you know. I mean, you got a political game, but, you know. You asked them to do something at a certain time, and that was almost two weeks ago.
When was that meeting?
More than 2 weeks.
Yeah, 2 weeks ago this past Tuesday.
Yeah. So, yeah. I mean, maybe they think state aid's going to come in differently. Maybe they think my numbers might change magically. I don't know.
That's been the argument every year. Let's wait till the end of June because my state aid might change. Because
the governor's.
Doesn't change.
Yeah. I think Ted agreed that he doesn't think state aid is really going to change, at least for Webster.
And I don't think they're at any point near agreeing on anything as best as I can decipher.
Yeah.
Is there a definite date when we know when we had a balanced budget or not? A projected balanced budget, because we all know it's not balanced anyway.
Yeah, well,
because it's been changing during the year.
May 8th.
What I presented in February, at the end of February, is a balanced budget. So that's what I'm going to go with if the school committee votes something on the 25th that is reasonable that everyone can work with, then we can change it then. But for now, what I presented is what the proposed budget is.
On the town side, there was proposals to not fill a position.
A couple.
Yeah. What's the status of that today?
Right. So whatever was proposed is what I'm doing. So, like, I'm not filling the recreation director. I have not filled any of the currently vacant positions because I knew the budget's still in flux. So that's where we are.
And I think you have on there deputy police chief.
Yep, so that has not been filled either.
What's that?
It has not been filled.
No, but you. I mean, is that going to be one of the items that's going to be considered to balance the budget?
Every unfilled position is obviously going to be under consideration if we need to make some adjustments to the budget.
I think there was another department that somebody retired or is going to retire as of July 1st.
Yeah, it's
the assessor.
Yeah, the assessor. Yeah. And right.
So what I was wondering for this committee is savings measures totaling $679,000 has been created by Doug. And what I'm wondering is, we out of that 679, we got to carve $340,000 out of that to make a balanced budget. And what I'm wondering from this committee is, should we zero out those cost savings measures and start with a positive budget with an excess and put positions back in as we interview the departments that are requesting these new or currently vacant positions?
On the, on the town side, not school.
Well, I don't know, can we make recommendations?
No.
Not to the school, no.
Okay.
Bottom line only.
Okay.
Through the chair, if I may. Finance committee is not charged with doing the budget.
No, but we're charged with making recommendations.
Making recommendations, yes.
But to start from another concept or an idea is doing another budget, right?
Okay.
Well, we actually, the town administrator's proposed budget may be subject to amendments by the finance committee per section 6-5 of the charter. So we can make amendments to the budget.
You wouldn't want to, but.
You wouldn't like them.
Through the chair, I believe you can also write, the finance committee could also write a budget, a compromising budget or a dueling budget with yours. I believe the law allows us to present our own budget.
Well, that's what I was.
So
asking
it would
the
be have to be, we'd have to iron out whether we, through the chair. 8 years ago, when Mr. McAuliffe came in, I had a long discussion with Mr. McAuliffe, and like Mr. Barisic said, Mr. McAuliffe, this is your budget. He said, Mike, I just got here in February. I said, I don't care, it's your budget. Sit down, do it. If you're not gonna do it, we'll write a totally new budget with the finance board. He did the budget, and for 8 years, he did the budget, and it was his privy. But we do have the right, and if some cases, maybe the obligation to write our own budget if we disagree. And we don't disagree with you at the present time, but anybody that comes in, any other finance committee down in the line, has that right. And I believe if you go back in history, and history always repeats itself, there was two budgets on the town meeting floor, the finance committee's budget and the town administrator's or interim town administrator's budget. For the first time in over 40 years, there were two separate budgets on the floor. So it's not something that wasn't done in the past and probably won't be, will not be done in the future. But again, we have to realize that the past always repeats itself. So we need these old farts out there to tell us what the hell went on 20, 30, 40, 50 years ago so we don't make that mistake 10 years down the line.
Yeah, and I was joking but to Sarah, but if you have recommendations that I think are good for the town, I'm certainly open to them. I will say though that, you know, by the time you take out the absolute fixed costs like the debt and the insurances and things like that, and then you take out the personnel, there's very, very little left to actually play with. And if we're going to look at personnel, I think you just have to look at the unfunded ones first, because if you cut funded ones, you're spending half as much money paying for the unemployment. And there's very, very little savings by actually laying off an employee.
I think, though, that part of the purpose of going over and prioritizing which of these positions we might recommend,
yep,
would be helpful, especially in an open forum like this. We could have the department heads, you know, plead their case as to why they need this position or how high of a priority is it, or is there some other
that's
position?
What I meant.
That's very appropriate. Yeah.
To just look at it, flip it and look at it a different way. Instead of these are cost savings measures, these are additions that we remove it, and these are necessary additions that we want to put back
and
into
prioritize
the
them, because we don't know what's going to happen. We don't know what kind of thing we're going to have to deal with in 4 days?
Yeah, no, in my mind, I have a prioritized list, but I would be more than happy to know what your guys' is.
Well, we would like, I think, the input from those department heads in order to prioritize them. And given that it's an open forum where, you know, the presenter can come in and present their case, and then people can hear their case.
Yeah.
So I think we have, four positions on the town side?
Right.
in different departments?
Two of them, there's a department head.
Right.
Yeah. So I think I said earlier that I was not filling any of the positions. I have offered the position of town planner to someone. To me, that's the most important position of all the currently vacant ones.
Okay, so that's your number one.
I think we're probably in agreement, the town planner.
You're up for the position.
I look at positions to be filled, the positions that can bring revenue into this town versus us.
I agree.
A person being an expense.
That's my question. What is our, as we add things, what is our return? What is our possible return? Is there some value for spending this money that returned in other ways to the town, and prioritizing those? As I think the school, again, we can't talk about it, but I think they need to start prioritizing things based on a return.
As I know of a town planner, there are many aspects of it. But it does not, the town planner, in all respect, he or she, does not convince Big Lots to move into the ice shop. That's a management decision for their business. It's good for us, okay? Or some medical facility going up on Route 12. The town planner is not going to encourage that. Because they're going to know the town planner is more or less, I'm not saying a restrictive type of thing, but making sure that the town is protected by state law, by law, and whatever type of planning, whether it be zoning or whatever the case might be. Okay? But it doesn't encourage, that position doesn't really encourage businesses to come into the town.
Yeah. I think a lot depends on the personality of the planner. If they're strictly, focused on regulating the zoning bylaw, then, they might actually be a hindrance to people moving into the town. So candidate, I think, is going to be very good at making the community more business friendly, making sure that the process is an easy one for businesses that are trying to move into and open the town. I think she'll be able to go through and make recommendations to update the zoning bylaw to make it appropriate for the community, both the business side and for the residents. There's a lot of things that a business plan or a town planner can do. There's a lot of programs available for local businesses that they have no idea even exist. So the planner is going to be the liaison between the business community and all the resources out there. So. I agree with you that if you get the wrong person in there, they could actually kill business. But that's not what the way we're going.
I think it's all based too on the chair. I think it's all based on what type of job description we give this town.
Yeah, I was going to ask that.
Yeah, and
it's not,
and the vision and so on. And
right,
so
right.
Forth.
Even the title is Planner Economic Development Director. Right. So.
In your job description, did you put grant writer?
I don't know if it exactly is. So the candidate I know is would be
we need
much,
a, we need a qualified grant writer desperately.
Yeah. If you have the grants identified, yes, this person would be willing and very capable to do that.
So back to the discussion on the pleasure of this. Committee, as far as bringing the department heads to this committee to plead their case, so that we can get a greater understanding of what it does and what it doesn't do for the town.
Well, Jay, you got 3-4 weeks for town meeting.
Yeah.
A bit of time on the.
Well, we got 3-4 weeks.
We've always had the department heads before us, but I don't know what we're going to do. What are you going to do with an elected official says I don't have to come before you? I'm an elected official.
Well, that's
their prerogative.
That's their prerogative, certainly.
Okay, that's what I did. I asked what you were gonna do, and apparently it's nothing, zero.
What?
Correct?
Huh?
If an elected official is asked to come before the board to plead their case, and they say no.
I don't think we have a right to, I don't know. I mean, we'd have to find out.
There's nothing that we can do, I mean, okay.
So.
But it would be publicly noted that they did not come.
No.
Mr. Chair, I just wanna make a comment about the municipal government, which is basically this building, and the offices. Some of them have, maybe I'll take one person. Some have two, some have three. We're down, this municipality is down to its bare minimum, quite frankly, to operate, unless you keep on outsourcing. You know, you're getting your excise tax bill now from somebody out in Milford, then you get your water and sewer bill from somebody out in East Bovishu. That's what I mean by outsourcing, okay? And I'm not citing a certain department. I just, you know.
Yeah.
Tax bills get printed, outsourced. So assessments, we pay somebody $70,000 a year to go out and revalue one third of the town, and then we have a triennial certification, right? That the cities and towns have to have in Massachusetts. And, you know, but I think this building, these offices, I don't know, I would wanna be the department head because they're down to the bare minimum, they're down to their knuckles, honest to goodness, even with the technology that we have. I don't know where we would, what are these people gonna do to operate unless we outsource more and more? That's my opinion.
Sure, I just have a question. If we do have the department heads come in for the committee to come together with a priority list, mm-hmm. how are we going to decipher that later on through the budget? If the town administrator already has his budget, but our priority list is different, do we have to put forth our own budget, or?
What I'm thinking, I mean, we have the choice of creating our own budget.
Sure.
It's already been, but I think if we take what's recommended, I mean, these are unfilled new or holding positions right now, and prioritize and recommend at town meeting. We,
okay.
we have to present a report at town meeting
okay.
on our recommendations.
Yep.
So we can either recommend to accept whatever whoever puts up, or we can come back with what we think.
What we would like to recommend.
Is a benefit that we feel, in our opinion, as a group, as a body, what we feel, the town, I mean, what they can vote whatever they wish to vote.
That's, to the chair, that's why when at the town meeting, if we go through a department and we get to a line item budget, a line item, and the department head has argued the point that we agree, we can make a recommendation to up the line item.
Okay.
On the town meeting floor. What the town meeting does, they're the ultimate decide is the town meeting. We just advise the town meeting to what we think would be best for the town, as the town administrator does with the budget. He decides what's best for the town and dollar for dollar. But it's if they, we go to town meeting and they decide to not vote on a budget, we don't have a budget. We go to a 1/12 budget as of July 1 until one could be established. And it's happened before. Like I said, the past is always something you should learn from. We did have a 1/12 budget at one time.
Through the chair, our ending recommendation may align with the town administrator's
right.
recommendations. We're just looking to get the information.
Oh, I agree. I just wanted to have an idea of how we go forward after that with that information.
Town meeting.
Information
later
on. Yeah.
Town meeting. Yeah, it could be on town meeting floor, or we could meet before then and
yeah.
not have to.
And another point, I think at the last tri-committee meeting, I think Mr. Bork had recommended that these three committees get back together. There was no date set. But I do think that this has to be hashed out. I don't know.
I do believe, through the chair, I was at one town meeting where a motion was made to approve the budget as presented and passed, and we walked out within 15 minutes. So that's a phenomena
that could occur again also.
We, the draft in the budget was passed without a question, so.
Really?
Are you kidding?
No, serious, like, every year.
So if you ever sit, you should go on the website and see the presentation that they put out.
Put a nice one on.
I mean, it's prior to going to town meeting, you know, ands, ifs, or buts, and all your questions were answered. I mean,
And how was attendance?
Wonderful job in drafting, putting their presentation together for the residents, which is something Webster has never seen. But they had, you know, a lot of people, common residents, you know, they look at a budget and numbers go crazy. If they see diagrams, pie charts, flow charts, everything is in black and white, you know, color, it makes a big, big difference, and they have an better understanding.
Yeah, it's my intention to do that here as well, and actually hold the town meeting info sessions before as well. And,
yeah, the time.
And record one, so we don't get to see it online. Yeah, yeah, but that takes a lot of time.
It does.
So the meeting is May 8th, correct?
May 8th.
And we still have to have a public hearing, correct?
Correct.
Right. And that's why, and there's 3 weeks, there's 2 weeks in between. There's still weeks in between all of this.
Yeah, so would you want to?
And we have to have a published report.
Yes, at town meeting, yes.
No, 7 days prior.
Yeah, yeah. So it can be printed out and included with the board's.
Yeah, but does it have to be in the paper?
2 weeks, we should instruct our secretary to get the announcement in the paper for the public hearing.
Oh yeah, no.
Yeah,
I,
but your recommendations don't have to be printed in the newspaper.
No.
Because
no.
That's
presented at town meeting.
Yeah, so.
Distributed 7 days before the town.
So we
Can I make a recommendation that you, if you want to meet with department heads, do that. And then I would say wait till after the 25th, maybe on the 26th or something, or 27th, because you guys like Thursdays. Meet on that day, and you'll know exactly what the school committee has voted. But I don't know, maybe you want to have your recommendation
have
before.
Time, because we have to have a public, do we
want you'd have to have a public hearing.
Yeah. So I was thinking the public hearing probably has to occur on the 27th at the latest.
Yep.
You're
probably
right. Before the town meeting, yeah, 7 days, so.
I will not be available from the 19th to the 26th.
27th is not a good day for me.
When will you be available?
27th.
When will you be available?
Up to the 19th, and then from the 19th through the 26th, I'm going. I'm in North Carolina.
Oh, so you will be available on 27th.
Yeah.
Good.
Yeah.
But Mr. Willis,
I will not be.
You won't.
He's kind of a key component.
Will you be available on the 28th?
The Friday? No.
No.
If we did it, it would have to be very early on Thursday. But
we'd have to do it without the town administrator. I have a very dumb question to ask, and I realize there's no such thing as dumb questions. But if you're unavailable and we have, because of time restraint, we have to have the meeting on the 27th, could we instruct the town accountant to be here to answer any questions the public may have at a public hearing?
You could.
I wouldn't suggest that. Do we need to have the school committee's budget accepted before we meet the department heads? If it's just to figure out the priority of the town side?
Well, it's better to have
would be
solid.
Easier. However,
we could just combine them later on.
But also we have to have it 7 days before town meeting, so everybody's cutting it close.
The idea is that the school committee, the finance committee, and the selectmen go into town meeting unified with one purpose and one budget.
Yeah. And
we don't want to battle it out on the town meeting floor.
And my hope was actually that would have happened at the tri-committee meeting because we were all in the same room. And
right. That was very
we all just kind of looked at each other and left, so.
Again, I say, time is not on your side.
No, I know.
And 99.9% of the fiscal budget, fiscal 18 budget, is prepared.
Right.
Yeah.
For us to go back, as you suggested, it is not enough time.
Not productive.
I believe all we're looking for is the department heads that relate to these unfilled positions.
Basically, we only have one department head.
Two, yeah.
One, two.
Yeah, police and the assessors.
And Mr. Willardson for...
That's why the subcommittees in January or February should have went out and talked to these department heads and brought the information back to this board.
Or invite them to the board, one of the two.
I think in the future, that'll be our plan.
So I'll entertain a motion if anybody's got a motion, but otherwise we'll move on.
Well, I'll make a motion that we set up some kind of a schedule to incorporate all these necessary events prior to the town meeting.
Well, I think that's...
We're gonna schedule them. The motion is to create the schedule.
Second.
Okay, any discussion?
One piece of discussion. Would it be acceptable to have the department heads, if they weren't able to make it to the meeting, draft a actual letter explaining why they need this position filled?
I think any information that, I mean, all now, what we got is a number. That's all we got. Anything that they can provide to support that.
We could even schedule something on a Saturday if that was more convenient.
Right.
You know, by the time you...
Other towns do that.
How about Thursday the 20th?
I mean,
six p.m.
We've got the 13th, we got the 20th.
Yeah, the 13th, this room is taken.
Doesn't have to be here.
Yeah, we can do it somewhere else. You could do it the same night. You could even have...
I think the 13th.
The department heads come in and then hold your public hearing after that. Just an option.
That's true. We could do that as well. Depending on if they're willing, when they can come.
Or,
so
yeah.
First we need to find
meet,
out.
Meet on the 13th, invite the department heads in if you want to do that, and then have your public hearing on, I would prefer the 26th.
Okay.
I don't have a problem, because the school committee meets on the 25th, is that?
Yeah.
That's the drop deadline for them to
yeah, I mean, if they don't have something. It done by then.
Then, yeah.
We just go home, because.
Yeah.
Yeah, one last thing. What scares the hell out of me is we all know who has more attendance at the town meeting, correct?
We have more attendance.
Like I said, we know who has more attendance
right.
on one side than the other, and that's the town employees.
Right.
So if you think they're going to take a dive, no, it's not going to happen. They'll say, go and do the budget. We want our people. They'll vote them in. Okay, get the money.
I think we're all going to do this, and I think we're all going to be able to compromise on a very
hope so.
Good.
We're going to have to.
Yeah, yeah. I mean, I'm very confident.
We're just delaying the obvious. We
yeah, exactly. That. Yeah, right.
That would, you know what? You would become mayor of the city, not just the town of Bisbee.
Electronic voting will change that.
Well, your attendance has to be there for
yeah, me. Electronic voting.
So,
and there will be electronic voting, but I don't know that
yeah.
If I could, I would make a motion for the 13th and 26th, but not that I don't want you there, Neil, but.
Could I ask
well,
Mr.
if
Dixon
I get in town,
question?
That's my travel day. If I'm in town early enough, I'll be
yeah. Well, that's what I was going to ask you. Where do you expect to be on the 26th? We're allowed telephone conferencing now.
Yeah, you could.
I'll be on the road. That's a travel day for me. I have a good, you know, if it's a good travel day, I should be in town around, I'm saying, maybe 4 o'clock, 4:30.
Well, let's meet at
that's
two.
Why they make cell phones. That's why they make cell phones.
Okay, are we all in agreement to the public hearing for the Wednesday the 26th?
Yes.
I'm available.
Okay.
And meeting next week, tentatively with the department
are
heads?
Are we doing it at 6 or 7?
I think... It's usually
seven,
isn't it?
Yeah.
Depends on what the
yeah, I know. Isn't it usually seven?
I think it's seven.
You usually meet at seven.
Yeah. Yeah. So public hearing, 7 p.m. on Wednesday, the 26th. Chris, can you make sure it gets in the... So that's got to appear in the newspaper on the 20th. The Webster Times comes out the 20th. Wednesday, Thursdays, right?
On Thursday.
So they've got to receive the ad, either the 14th or the 17th, so that they can get it into the paper for Thursday, the 20th.
Yeah, I don't know what the
deadline is.
I can check. It's Friday.
Yeah, check. Yeah, okay. So you'll take care of getting that notice? And what about, should we invite the department heads, or will you invite them, or how do we proceed?
How about you invite them and let me know what the response is?
Okay.
To the chair, I think if not putting any pressure on the secretary, but if she gets it in by noon tomorrow to Stonebridge Press, mm-hmm. it'll be in the 14th paper. I believe their deadline is noon on a Friday.
Yeah, but we've got the notice has to appear within a window before the hearing.
7 days.
7 days. So that would, if we get it in on the 20th,
it's
and
perfect.
The 26th, that's perfect.
Do we need to take an actual vote for the public hearing? Does that have to be
right now
formalized as a vote, or
the schedule of it?
Schedule of it?
We can.
No, I'm asking that.
I don't
have no idea.
Wouldn't hurt to have it on the books.
Yeah
right.
Do you want to put a motion?
A motion. I'll make a motion that we have the public hearing on
April 26th at 7 p.m. Wednesday, April 26th.
I'll second that.
Okay, any discussion?
Mr. Chair, we didn't have a vote on this committee meeting with the bodies.
Okay. Okay, well, we
got to make an amendment to that motion.
To this motion?
No.
The motion that hasn't come up yet.
Is there a motion on the floor? Or are you putting, you're making
a motion? No, no, it was already, and Mr. Becker seconded.
To set up a schedule.
There was nothing, no motion.
Okay, so then I'd like to make a motion that instead of this committee meet, the chairman and vice chairman meet to the department heads, or report to the committee at some point in time.
Okay.
Second.
Well, we have a motion on the floor, I think. We need to act.
Yeah,
on
yeah. You should probably just vote on that one and then go to that one.
Any discussion about meeting on the 26th at 7, public hearing? Okay, all in favor?
Aye. Aye.
Opposed? Okay, motion carries. So, Mr. Brzezik, you have a motion?
Yes, sir. Did you have a... Instead of the entire committee meeting, I'd like to make a motion that the chairman and vice chairman meet with the department heads, which are, what, two or three?
Three, yeah.
And, they make a recommendation based on...
And bring it back
to
this committee?
Yeah.
I would actually rather have it in open forum and televised for the public, their presentations.
Well, we have a motion.
Okay,
let's open that for discussion.
Okay, discussion. I think we already had one member say, would a letter to you be sufficient? Guess what? With all due respect, that leaves the door open for them not being here. With all due respect.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Which means...
Well, it's good you made a motion, so let's get that on the floor and open it up for discussion. If we
second,
get...
I second the motion.
Okay,
yeah.
We have a motion.
Put discussion,
second.
Go ahead.
That only the chair and the vice chair meet with the department heads? Is that
right.
What the motion is?
Yes. So we have a motion and second. I'll open it up for discussion. What is everyone's feeling?
I just have faith in the chairman and vice chair.
I'm sorry?
So I have great faith in the chairman and the vice chair to do that and report to us accordingly and without an increase in any stipend either.
Being it so late in the process, I think Mr. Brzezik has hit on something. You might be able to extract more information out of the department head than they're willing to give in open session to 3 weeks before the budget.
I have no problem. It's the pleasure of the committee.
My main point is this. I don't think the department has wants.
Should we meet with them televised?
Mike and I, whatever you want to say.
Let's take a vote. You got.
Yeah.
Let's take a vote.
Any other discussion? Okay, let's take a vote.
Roll call, please.
Yeah, okay.
This is to have the chairman and vice chair.
It's correct.
To meet with, and report back to this committee.
Maybe I'll refuse.
That'll be reported.
Mr. Becker?
Yes.
Mr. Borisov?
Yes.
Mr. Dixon?
Yes.
Mr. Fittimore?
Yes.
Ms. Marsha?
Yes.
Ms. Sampson?
No.
Mr. Gabriel?
Yes.
Is that a yes?
Yes.
Well, I was counting.
No, did you say yes?
Yes.
Yes.
Yes or no?
So if they can't do the Thursday, the 13th, I'm more than willing to move it to the 20th.
Well, I was going to
stand and watch how it gets biggest.
Talk about that. We don't have to put that in the minutes, but. So we'll make contact with those three department heads or TA and report back to the committee.
What day?
That brings us, yeah, that brings us to the next.
We don't know what day.
Well, this is the budget month. This is where things are going to happen. The Board of Selectmen are meeting on the 10th. I think we have the 13th and 20th, two Thursdays. After that, to find out where they are with the 180,000 and maybe have some more insight and prepare a presentation for town hearing and also work on our report to town meeting. So I think we should meet at least one of those weeks.
The 20th. I make a motion we meet on the Thursday, the 20th here at 7. Can we do 6:30? So we get out of here before.
Well, these guys are coming from Boston.
Oh, they can't come in. 7 o'clock. Okay. No. Good. 7 o'clock is good.
We can just talk less and get out of here.
You're cutting into my box with time.
So we have a motion to meet on the 20th.
April 20th. Yeah.
At 7 o'clock, Thursday, the 20th.
I will not be here.
Okay. Any second?
Second.
Okay. Any other discussion? All in favor?
Aye.
Aye. Opposed? Okay. So we jumped around a little bit, but.
Motion to adjourn?
No, we still got some. Hey, it's. This is a short meeting for us. Financial policy liaison report. Do you have anything?
We have a draft. We have permission from the. What do they call it?
DLFs, is it?
Local services, the
public
services.
To use some of the ones that they put out for other towns and adapt them for our use. So currently it looks like this.
Excellent.
And it has a.
Could you send a list of the policies you're working on, financial policies, to this committee?
When I think we plan on presenting them to the finance committee and the selectmen.
Right.
Okay.
Because they have to be
approved. Yes.
Yeah. But
yes.
If you're wondering generally what's in there, if you look up the, which one did we do?
I think it was
Charlton.
Charlton was, yeah.
I just want to know what policies, is that what it is? Okay.
Yeah.
Can I have that?
You may.
Chris will distribute this.
We might add one or two more.
We may add one or two more based on.
Okay, at least we'll have a general idea on what you know.
Did I don't think it is because you told me they added it on there.
I can forward it to somebody.
I can give them the one that we have so far with little comments even.
Yeah.
I'd be happy just with the, you know, you're going to present the policies. I'd just like to know what policies you're and look. I'm going to look back to what the audit report suggests. And I, you know, I don't looking for, but...
Ours is going to be better than what the auditors.
That's fine. That's fine.
Theirs were pretty much boilerplate. We're making some change.
Okay. Next item on the agenda was capital plan.
Yeah, so I have a handout. So this, take one and pass it around. So as part of the budget process, I requested that department heads give me capital needs for the coming year.
Just the coming year?
Well, I asked for 5 years.
Yeah, okay.
So this document only has, what, 18 would be? Yeah.
Okay.
So a lot of these are to be funded with free cash. We don't have any free cash, so this would have to wait for October. So it's not exactly a rush on this. Also, one of the big items on there was a fire rescue truck. I was talking with the chief. There's probably going to be some changes there as well, so.
Say what again?
There's probably going to be changes in what the fire chief has recommended as a purchase for a new fire apparatus.
We just bought $1.5 million.
I know. So this is what was requested.
This is the wish list.
Yeah.
Yeah, wish list is a... What is
it? Only a cup of coffee a day, Joseph.
Is that for the lake?
What's that?
The floor vessel. Is that for the lake?
Yes, yes.
Police? Oh, won't they say boat then?
So on the, in the...
Sounds fancy.
On the water, that won't come out of the enterprise?
No, they will.
Oh.
So I on the back it has a little bit of an explanation.
Oh, okay.
Mr. Willetson, could we add to that patrol vessel kayak? They got to lose some weight somewhere.
We save a little money, yeah. So I will say that the water main extension replacement project will be on the warrant for the May town meeting. So, and it's not just the 80,000. The 80,000 is the design portion of it. I don't think it makes much sense to ask for 80,000 when we know the project's going to be.
For your information, through the chair, this was on in 1993.
The
water superintendent said the water main on Main Street is 125 years old. It has to be replaced.
Yeah.
That's why we started the stabilization account for the water department, and we never got the water main replaced.
Yeah, so actually that, funny you say that, because the water main on Main Street out here is actually not that bad. I mean,
right.
It's not great, but...
Better shape than some of the other.
Yeah, yeah,
right.
So that was not going to be funded. CDBG was thinking about doing a big project downtown, which... We didn't want to do this huge, nice project and put in all new pavement and then have to rip it up and do the...
But that's why we need a grant writer. I can go back again in history when this entire town could have been sewered free of charge prior to 1975. Free of charge. And we procrastinated and wound up having to pay for our own sewer and installation. So I don't want to, if there's something out there that says that because of the Clean Water Act and because of Flint, Michigan, all water problems are going to be solved by the federal government, let's jump in there and get some of that federal government money.
If the federal government was giving away money, we'd take it, yes. the water main extension project that is going to be on the Maytown meeting warrant is for... replacement and extension on Thompson Road from Memorial Beach Drive down to Park Road. So with the new filtration plant being put in.
Okay, that's a primary.
Yeah, so it has to get from the filtration plant to the water tank. Mm-hmm. So you got to do that. Yeah.
Didn't we just do that on Wilson Road?
No. No. So there's a portion that's brand new and there's a portion that's...
This is not
Wilson
Road.
Thompson
Road.
Oh, Thompson, I thought I heard Wilson Road, I'm sorry.
No.
Now, let me ask you, we talked about National Grid gas is going to be tearing up Main Street. Do you have any idea?
When? Late spring, summer.
Okay.
Yeah.
That's going to be a mess, and then they're going to patch.
The hope is, I'm meeting with them later this month.
Okay.
We're going to push for them to do curb to curb, because that would be awesome.
But is that water main, if it gets funded?
Oh, it's a little farther down. So the water main on Main Street is right in front of this building, basically, and the gas stuff would be
further
a little
down.
Farther down.
Okay. That's going past the railroad tracks, isn't it?
The gas?
Yeah.
I am not entirely sure.
Okay. I know they were measuring.
I think
through the chair, the body cams, have the union and the police agreed to body cams?
I'll have to double check on that. I thought they already had them, so anyway, I'll have to look into it more.
It is for their own protection.
Yeah, yeah.
I wonder if they actually did agree to it.
Yeah.
Or is this?
You hear on the radio, Boston. They were having an issue with it, but I think they're now.
Boston's agreed to it.
Yeah, right.
They just didn't have the money.
Yeah. On the personal advisory board, any update? Or?
You want to do
we
it?
We had our second meeting this week, and we've got our list of priorities together, and I don't really remember what they are other than to get our employee handbook first.
Oh, okay.
Then I know Doug wants to have an evaluation checkoff list to do evaluations, a welcome kit for new employees, and there are two others, but I don't remember.
Job descriptions.
Okay, that's what I was wondering, because I know that's come up.
So there's a lot to be done,
yes,
but we're starting
yes.
with, those are our, we've got five top priorities that we're...
And I would assume you're probably...
Stealing.
Yeah. Say plagiarize.
No.
It sounds strange.
Come out with it. Yeah.
Stealing with
exchange.
Oh, we do have
yes.
attorneys in the room.
Yes.
So, yeah.
Okay. New business. You have in your packet from Chris the review of the bylaw 110 that pertains to the Finance Committee. I've been asked, Bylaw Review Committee is organized, and I think they've met once or twice. They're just getting into gear for the coming year. It follows the charter review and then the bylaws so that they go hand in hand. But we've been asked, this committee, to review the bylaws like we did earlier with the charter review, asking to review the charter. So I think we should look this over. A couple of comments on the first section committee. Obviously, it needs to go hand in hand with the charter review, which is a recommendation from 15 to 9. Obviously, section 3.9 in the charter will be compatible with that change. Also on 110-2, limits on who may serve B, there is no capital planning advisory committee, to my knowledge.
I don't know of anything.
Never was. So I think we need to look at that and possibly remove that. I don't know if you...
Wasn't there one not that long ago?
I'm not aware of one. Because we haven't done capital.
Wasn't Mr. McAuliffe working?
I don't know. But one person is not. That's
no, and I don't mean I don't mean just him. No,
oh,
I mean
with a group.
With the group,
okay.
The whole French River Park mm-hmm. and
oh, okay.
stuff. Wasn't that part of the?
I don't know. But there's nothing in the charter that relates to an advisory committee. If there was one, maybe it should be in the charter. I don't know. We'd have to decide. But there isn't one. So it may have been an ad hoc committee of some sort that the town administrator, but there's nothing in the charter that references this. So I don't know, you know, the bylaw is a lot easier to change if in the future they do put a capital advisory committee together. Do you foresee that possibility, Doug, at this point?
So it may make sense just to have a subgroup of the finance committee do it.
Well, that's what we had talked about at one time, but yeah.
Liaison group.
I have
liaison group, yeah, exactly.
A question of the chair. You were on this bylaw committee.
I'm not on the bylaw.
On the charter committee, I'm sorry, you were on the charter committee.
The chairman.
Okay. We did better with our budget when we requested the February 1st deadline. We extended it to the 28th for the convenience of the school. I do think that you should look in the next couple of weeks to go back to February 1st. It gives us a three-week head start on the budget.
Well,
and it also puts the department heads on notice that January, they should concentrate solely on the budget, upcoming budget. That extra 3 weeks kills us.
Yeah, I know it's killed us in the past only because February is not really, I think we had a pretty good budget pulled together by this February 28th.
Yeah.
Where in the past we...
Well, we didn't get the budget before February 28th. The school held off the March to give it to us.
Right.
Going back to February 1st, I think would benefit everybody.
Through the chair, I think it's actually Mr. Willardson's intent to actually get us a budget like in January.
Who said that? No.
Yeah.
No, well, to start this process way
I see
earlier.
The, you know, if we can agree, I can put it as a discussion point.
Please, because...
To me, the problem is not the date. The problem is that the school committee is just dragging it out. Like,
right.
If we had, I mean, even if they said this is the exact number we want, then we could at least play to that.
No, I know.
Yeah.
School committee is dragging through the chair.
Yeah
we did it
because I don't think they were in any position to get hit with them coming up with the $340,000. It's probably like a shock to them that it was being asked.
Yeah.
But
maybe
they normally
the
have their budget sitting pretty much by January.
Right. Oh yeah, they started.
Yeah,
absolutely.
They started.
You know what I mean?
Yeah. Yeah.
This way here, if we all have it earlier, we're not down to the wire trying to find how to get a public meeting here and there and how to do that. You know, Mr. Willison is, from his being in Grafton, I think you made a comment that you've always had it in like February 1st.
Yeah, I mean, that was what our charter said
in
Grafton.
You know, if it's in writing, it's going to happen. Don't put it in writing, it's not going to happen.
So I guess my point is, if it had been February 1st, it wouldn't have mattered. We still would have dragged it out until now.
Yeah.
I think that's an MO.
Yeah.
And I don't think that would improve the situation at all. But
at least it gives you, like Mr. Fenimore said, it gives us a couple more.
Yeah, well, we'll put it on the discussion, and you know, we'll look at that.
Can I add one thing to that? I mean, I guess a month doesn't make that much of a difference, but if you start looking out too far ahead, like...
Things change, and then
and
it's almost worse.
You're looking like... You're trying to figure out where you're going to spend in 18 months. I mean, that's kind of hard to do.
Yeah.
So.
I agree, but I'll put it on the agenda, and we can certainly discuss it, you know, at the Charter Review Committee, and we'll come back with that.
Thank you.
Yeah. And also on C, members of finance may serve on the personnel. Although it does, right now all I'm thinking is we have two people appointed to the personal advisory board. But I'm reading now, it does say members of, I thought it said member of the finance committee. Oh, no, it said members
or
finance.
Non-members.
Well, may appoint a member or a non-member. That's in the singular.
Yeah.
So should we?
But members is plural, right?
Well, members of the finance committee may appoint a member or a non-member. So that, to me, that's.
I don't think it has to be.
We can all appoint one person. And in practice, we're appointing two people. So I think that, you know, we should recommend that practice, that policy follow practice.
Yep.
Or what?
It really, I don't think it makes a difference, singular or plural.
Well, I'm just saying the written should follow the practice. That's all I'm saying.
Mm-hmm. Yep.
We got two lawyers over there, ask them.
Well, they're shaking their head.
Words matter.
Yeah.
Yes.
Two members. May appoint up to two members. So that gives us the flexibility.
No, I'd rather leave it, appoint two members definitively than up to two members.
Okay.
Please.
Yeah, well, we'll present that recommendation to the bylaw, the ultimate. So I guess I'm going to get back to the bylaw committee with this. They're just starting to ramp up, but if we could look this over with further recommendations for the next time we meet.
Yeah.
Next topic was finance committee member status. I think both Chris and I, this is in regard to Julie Delano, who's attended two meetings since since the fiscal year, since last July. Chris has tried to reach her by email and phone call, I believe, and has not gotten a response. I just learned tonight she has probably moved.
She did move because she came in.
Oh, so you have her new?
I have her new address.
Okay, so she hasn't responded. So I'm looking for the recommendation of this committee to send a certified letter out to her as per the charter, with the idea of either she has to respond or we're going to remove her from the committee. And that frees up, you know, if we have a position. It's not hindering our quorum. No.
Did any?
I'm sorry?
The term ends in 17.
Didn't her appointment
right.
end this year?
It will end, yes.
Yeah.
Yes.
I think it's a moot point to send her anything at this point because we only got a couple of more months.
Okay.
I would not.
My only concern is with elections coming and there's, what, three positions?
Two.
Three? Two?
Two.
Three are coming up. There's a one.
There's
year
a one year
two,
and
two,
two
years.
And two, two
so
years.
Three are coming up. So that conceivably could change.
But she wasn't elected. She was appointed by the moderator.
I understand that.
Yeah. So she won't have any effect on anything, except for the moderator. We won't have to worry about not appointing anybody.
Mr. Chair, would it be appropriate to send this to the line, a letter, you know, very nicely worded, indicating that, you know, her presence at, I'm not saying it's going to be worded that way.
Greatly missed.
At the meeting it's been missed and noted. Something to the effect where, and a copy to the person, the moderator?
Moderator.
I've been talking to Tom about this. We're following the charter, per se.
I know, but I'm just saying,
the next step is this board has to approve on sending a certified letter out. We can compose it properly, but it has to go out certified.
And she comes up.
And the moderator won't act till that's done.
Oh, okay.
She's got 10 days, per the charter, she's got 10 days to respond.
You need a motion?
I'm looking for a motion, yes.
So moved.
To send a certified letter out to her.
So moved.
Second.
Any other discussion?
I think it's a moot point, but.
Well.
It's on the record.
It's on the record.
It's
that's
on the
out.
Record.
That's out. And all in favor?
Aye.
Aye. Aye.
Opposed? Okay. So Chris, I'll work with you to get a letter and I'll bring it out here to be certified. You can just email it to me. Sign it. Put it in the mail. Okay, we already talked about April and May meeting schedule. I think for the newer members, I'm sorry?
We didn't talk about May.
Well, that, I was just going to say, for the newer members, typically we've met prior to the same night as the town meeting at 6 p.m. To go over anything. You know, seems like things might be going to the last minute. But, yes.
For the bylaws,
yeah.
It says we're supposed to give a report to the selectmen a week before.
Yes.
If we're meeting on the 26th, when do we put the packet together?
We're meeting on the 20th.
Okay, sorry.
So that's the night I wanted to work on getting that together. This will be a working.
And I think, to the chair, I think what the chairman was trying to emphasize that things occur right up to the 11th hour. That's why we have a meeting on at 6 p.m. or the night of the town meeting. The selectmen have it with the town administrator. We have one. And if there's anything, and the school committee has one. So if there's any changes that have to be made, nobody gets blindsided.
Anything else? Motion?
To adjourn.
I'm sorry?
Do you want me to check with the Bylaw to see if we can get that conference room?
Yep, check with.
Before the selectmen, yes, please. Please, thank you.
Motion to adjourn?
Motion to adjourn.
Second?
Second.
All in favor?
Aye.
Aye. Opposed? Now, we're supposed to have a discussion now, until, or the camera's still on?
Isn't that bad?
How you shutting the camera off?
Doug's texting him.
I will text him to have him turn it off. So you're still live, just so you know.
Yeah.
Not mine.
I'm glad I'm live.
We came in that way.
Neil, if we went much longer, I was going to have you move.
No, nothing yet. He's on ice. There's a question. No, the a physician at one of the hospitals had a question on the what do they call it? More the
yeah, we'll see. Thank you.
Held up until this question can be answered. Medical exam.
Yeah. Well, we're going to have to go get some Chinese food. I'm hungry again.
They questioned the home death because of the accident that he had falling into the ground a year ago.
So Chris,
might have to change.
I'm over there.
Every day, just pass it out. I do a